Rest to find 1 minus 2 thirds plus 4 ninths minus 8 27ths plus dot 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 plus the 16th power of negative 2 thirds. And we're told to use the multiply, shift, and subtract method. So the first thing to recognize here is that we have a sum of a geometric sequence where the common ratio r equals negative 2 thirds. Notice 1 times negative 2 thirds equals negative 2 thirds. Negative 2 thirds times negative 2 thirds is positive 4 ninths, and 4 ninths times negative 2 thirds is negative 8 27ths, and so on. So again, we have a sum of a geometric sequence where the common ratio r is equal to negative 2 thirds. And I will determine the sum using the multiply, shift, and subtract method. We begin by writing an equation where we have s equals the sum and difference, which is 1 minus 2 thirds plus 4 ninths minus 8 27ths plus dot 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 plus. We know the last term is the 16th power of negative 2 thirds. The term before this would be the 15th power of negative 2 thirds. So let's write plus the 15th power of negative 2 thirds and then plus the 16th power of negative 2 thirds. The next step is to form a second equation by multiplying both sides of this equation by the value of r, which is negative 2 thirds. So on the left, we have negative 2 thirds s equals, when writing the terms on the right, we shift them to the right. The first product is negative 2 thirds times 1, which is negative 2 thirds. We write the negative 2 thirds in the second equation below the negative 2 thirds or minus 2 thirds in the first. The next product is negative 2 thirds times negative 2 thirds, which is positive 4 ninths, giving us plus 4 ninths. The next product is negative 2 thirds times 4 ninths, which is negative 8 27ths, giving us minus 8 27ths plus dot dot dot. Now going back up to the first equation just for a moment, the term right before the 15th power of negative 2 thirds would be plus the 14th power of negative 2 thirds. And notice when we multiply negative 2 thirds by the 14th power of negative 2 thirds, we do get plus the 15th power of negative 2 thirds. The next product is negative 2 thirds times the 15th power of negative 2 thirds, which gives us plus the 16th power of negative 2 thirds. And then the last product is negative 2 thirds times the 16th power of negative 2 thirds, which gives us the 17th power of negative 2 thirds. And now we subtract the second equation from the first equation, which means we subtract here on the left and we subtract here on the right. On the left, s minus negative 2 thirds s simplifies to s plus 2 thirds s, which is 5 thirds s. Remember, s is equal to 3 thirds s, and 3 thirds s plus 2 thirds s is 5 thirds s. And on the right, we have the 1 from the first equation, and then we start subtracting, and all the differences will be 0 except the last one. To begin, negative 2 thirds minus negative 2 thirds is equivalent to negative 2 thirds plus 2 thirds, which is 0. Next, we have 4 ninths minus 4 ninths, which is 0. Next, we have negative 8 27ths minus negative 8 27ths, which is 0. As we keep going, the 15th power of negative 2 thirds minus the 15th power of negative 2 thirds is 0. And the 16th power of negative 2 thirds minus the 16th power of negative 2 thirds is also 0. But then we are left with minus the 17th power of negative 2 thirds, which gives us 5 thirds s equals 1 minus the 17th power of negative 2 thirds. And now to find the sum, we solve for s. To do this, we multiply both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of 5 thirds, which is 3 fifths. Simplifying, 3 fifths times 5 thirds is equal to 1. 1 times s is s. We have s equals 3 fifths times the quantity 1. And then we have minus the 17th power of negative 2 thirds. But notice the 17th power of negative 2 thirds is going to be negative. Subtracting a negative is equivalent to adding a positive. And therefore, we can write this as plus the 17th power of 2 thirds. So this is the exact sum Let's see what the calculator gives us for this value. The calculator is giving us a decimal approximation, and therefore we should give the sum as the exact expression, but we can also say the sum is approximately 0.6006. But again, it's always best to give the exact sum as the expression 3/5 times the sum of 1 and the 17th power of 2/3. I hope you found this helpful.